Welcome to all. Today we will see the river engineering. How's the process of river engineering and the classification of river training works. The first is types of river training works. Types of river training works is divided into the following types. The first is guide bank. This one. Second is granies and spurs. Third is levees and embankment. Fourth is bank protection and pitched banks. Fifth is pitched icelands. And sixth is miscellaneous method, that is river training without embankment and bandling. Now we will see the first classification of river training works. So high water training, it is also called as training or discharge. It is trend of providing sufficient and efficient, that is the C/S area, for the expeditious passage of maximum load, and it concerns mainly with the alignment and height of the embankments for given flood discharge. So second thing is low water training, also called training for depth, and it is trained the providing sufficient depth of navigation during the low stage of river. River having a three stage. The first one is young stage, second is youth stage, and third is old stage. On between that is the low stage of river. This achieved by the contraction of the width of the channel. Suppose the width channel is contracted, the mean water training is also called as training of sediment, means sediment load provided by the rivers. The river is trained to correct the configuration of river bed for efficient transport and also keeps the channel in good shape. And third thing is mean water training. Water training is the most important one, and based on this, high and low meaning training are designed. Types of river training works. First is guide bank system. They are made for guiding the stream near the structure. They are made for guiding stream near the structure. This confines it is reasonable width of the river. As it is designed by Bell, it is called the Bell bund, and the further developed a spring, and it's known as guide bank. It consists of heavily built embankment. This is a shaped of bell mouth or both sides to the channel. Usually only one embankment is required if the other end bank is high and stable. Granies or spurs. Granies, it is constructed transfer to the river flow, and it extend from the bank of the river up to the limit. They are also known as spurs and dikes and transverse dikes. Types of granies according to the material used: permeable groin, solid impermeable groin. According to its heights below high water, submerged granny and non-submerged granny. According to the function it series: attracting granies, deflecting granies, repelling granies, and sedimenting granny. Fourth, the special types of granies. Dinihis T-headed granies, Hockey type granies, Burma type of granies. These are the types of granies. Factors influence the choice of the designing granies. The first factor is fall velocity of the river. Second, width of the river. It is high low mean water level. Depth of waterway, height and nature of flood rise. Fourth is character of bed materials like sand, silt and shingles. Now, then next, materials available and funds. Amount of materials carried in stream. Purpose of granny. Contracts a river channel to improve its depth. It is a main purpose. Protects the river banks. Silt up the vicinity of creating a slack flow. Trains the flow along the certain course. And repelling granny. The granny is pointing towards the upstream at an angle of 10 to 13 degree to the line of normal to the bank. This deflects the current in perpendicular direction to itself. This current that comes in contact with the steel water are adjacent causes eddies and depressors. Eddies means swirling currents. The head of the granny should be strong, resist the swelling action of the current. A steel water pocket is formed upstream and suspended load that brought the river gets deposited in this pocket. Now deflecting grannies. Deflecting grannies has shorter length than repelling grannies. The river is laid perpendicular to the bank. It deflects the flow along. Then attracting grannies. These types of grannies point downwards the direction of normal flow. Thus these cause scour holes. Therefore they tend maintain and deep current close to the bank. Thus upstream face bears the frontal attack of the river. Hence, a heavy protection is not required the downstream slope. Length of the grannies. The length of grannies depends upon the magnitude of the river training required. The longer length of grannies is required if the current has the thrown on the other end to bank. So initially a shorter length is designed and the silting is done, length is extended. Impermeable grannies. Now impermeable or solid grannies do not permit any flow through them. The core of it's made of materials like sand, clay and gravels. The sides are heavily protected by stone pitching or concrete blocks. The side slope is varying from 2:1 or to 3:1 and front slope varying 3:1 to 5:1. The apron is provided at the bottom and the slope prevents the slipping of the stones. Now permeable grannies. They permit the flow of water through them. The erosive action is reduced the stream. In case the river water carries sediment load, it gets deposited near the grannies is the velocity is reduced. Advantages of permeable grannies. Cost. The first advantage is cost construction is cheap. Second is small quantity of stone is required. Hence it is this use in place where the stones is scarce. It has better performance. This doesn't change the flow. Hence no eddy scour are formed. Suitable for deep narrow rivers. Disadvantage of permeable grannies. They do not resist shock and pressure cause floating ice logs. These two types of grannies, permeable grannies, tree grannies and pile grannies. Tree grannies, a tree is a being held position with the wear along the banks of ties to heavy buoy. The tree should vary leafy with many branches. This reduces the velocity of flowing waters and helps in sedimentation. This deflects the currents. It is used for closing a river channel and opening the others. It checks the low flow. Pile grannies. They are constructed with the timber piles. These driven up the depth of 9 meter. Two, three rows main verticals are braced together by transverse and diagonals. Spacing between main verticals is 2 to 3. Two intermediates can embedded at least 1.5 meter below. These filled up alternate layers, brushwoods and stones. Sometimes they filter stand and acts as solid granite. To safeguard it against cover, an apron is built at the rate 1 meter of stone. Hockey granite. The granite is curved head, thus it is termed as hockey granite. It's look like hockey. It is blank. It is scour hole. This is scour hole, and it is a flow of direction. It increase attracting tendency of granite, and it does not protects the bank. Last is Denny granites. They are earthen embankment from the marginal bund. It has T-shaped head. The front perpendicular arm is 100 in length parallel to the current, as the head has a longer portion and it look like inverted L, that is the L shape, and this is the current of flow, and this is the river bank, and it is the direction of flow. And the head has slope and protected by stone. So this is the all overview of granites in the part of river engineering. Thank you.